Okay, this brain has the meninges still on part of it here. And this one's also really nice because we see the trigeminal nerve right here, which you will just see probably as a stump on yours. But the meninges, remember, has a portion that goes in between the longitudinal fissure as the falx cerebrae, and then it has a portion that goes between the cerebrum and the cerebellum as the tentorum cerebelli, and that's in the transverse fissure. On this section here, we have removed the dura mater. Remember, there's that subdural space, and then the arachnoid and the pia mater are still located here. We see the vessels that are within the subarachnoid space. This space here, you can see that underneath the arachnoid there into the subarachnoid space, there is a enlarged space for the cerebral spinal fluid. This is known as the cerebellomedullary cistern, and that is a prime place for collecting cerebral spinal fluid. Okay, so you can see all these elevations and grooves here. The grooves are sulci, the elevations are gyri. We're only going to identify a few of these, mostly for helping us locate things. We've got one little tiny sulcus here, the pseudosylvian sulcus, and the sylvian gyri is that right there. And then also up here, this one is not the best, but because we have a cross appearing here, that's called the cruciate sulcus. And so rostral to the cruciate sulcus is going to be our frontal lobe. Above our sylvian gyri up in here is going to be our parietal lobe. We're going to have here caudal to our pseudosylvian sulcus is going to be our temporal lobe. And this more caudal aspect will be our occipital lobe. Then we also have a sulcus here. Right here is the rhinal sulcus, and that is going to give us our piriform lobe ventral to that, and that's going to be our sensory for smell, our olfactory lobe. So remember, our frontal lobe is for motor, both inhibitory and excitatory. Our parietal is our somesthetic, which is sensory as well as some motor. Our temporal is going to be for hearing, and our occipital for sight. On the ventral aspect of the brain, I want you to be able to identify the olfactory bulbs, the optic nerves. The optic nerves come together at the optic chiasm, and then the optic chiasm divides into the optic tracts. Here we have the oculomotor nerves. And then here on either side of the pons, we have the trigeminal nerve. Make sure that you know all of the nerves and their functions, but these are the only ones that I want you to be able to identify on the brain. I previously mentioned the pons right here. Remember that the function of the pons is for your ability to just stand, normal standing. Also, it is kinesthesia. It's kinesthesia for the sensation of movement as well as your overall consciousness. Caudal to it here is the medulla oblongata, which is also important in kinesthesia, as well as because cranial nerves nuclei are located in it, that's part of its function as well. So when you transect your brain, you're going to do one right on midline. Try to get it as centered as you can all the way through. And then you'll also do one about here, which will show you the gray matter, white matter, the corona radiata, and also the lateral ventricle. On this section here, we have cut just off midline of the cerebrum, so that we could show you the gray matter and the white matter. Remember, the white matter in this region is the corona radiata. And we can also see the lateral ventricle here containing choroid plexus. Then here we've cut the cerebellum more down midline so that we could see the folia of the gray matter and the arbor vitae of the white matter. Remember, we don't initiate motion here, but we control the motion as far as how hard it is, how fast it is, the direction, and things like that. So this white area right here is the corpus callosum. Remember, those are fibers going from one cerebral hemisphere to the other. This nice round structure is the thalamus. So this space underneath it is the hypothalamus. And the hypothalamus is separated by the third ventricle. Remember, the thalamus is our relay station, and the hypothalamus is involved in controlling normal bodily functions. Its action is going to be upon the autonomic nervous system as well as the pituitary gland. And it is also going to be involved in effective behavior, in your responses such as a rage, escape, or pleasure response. And then also, it's important in your sleep-awake cycle. Here we can see the little pine cone-shaped pineal gland, which is important in secreting melatonin. We'll talk more about that when we talk about endocrine glands. Going from the third ventricle, we have the mesencephalic aqueduct, which then brings the fluid into the fourth ventricle, which is sitting here underneath the cerebellum. Also, we see here very nicely is the rostral colliculus and the caudal colliculus. The rostral colliculus being reflect response and orientation to sight, and the caudal to sound. Okay, so here's a really nice example of the falx cerebrae, as well as the tentorum cerebelli. Okay, so we can see the cerebellum here, we can see the thalamus here, we can see the pituitary gland, and the hypothalamus would be here, which controls that pituitary gland. The pons is sitting right there. Okay, pretty cool, huh?